Well, tonight we go to the man in charge of FairPoint Communications to get some answers. The company took over the Verizon email accounts over the weekend.
But since that time, thousands of customers haven't been getting their emails. It's a frustration expressed by a member of our U Local community.
I have been calling since Monday night and have not been able to get through. Tonight I tried online to do the online live chat. It has now been 2.5 hours checking the clock, and I am still in a holding pattern.
Well, Josh Davis takes this woman's concerns straight to the CEO to find out what's going on.
Yeah, guys, these are all emails or messages, that is, from people who just sent these in today. This top one here from about an hour ago, all of them angry about not having email. Today, we went straight to the top for answers.
My name is Joy. I just wanted to share some of my experiences with the whole FairPoint internet mess.
This is a video submitted to U Local by a viewer furious with FairPoint. As we've reported, thousands of customers have been without email since the weekend, FairPoint telling them to turn to live chat for answers. But as of Wednesday night, and more than 48 hours with no email, Joy can't get through to anyone in customer service on the phone or online.
After 2.5 hours, they booted me off the waiting list for the live chat. Great work, FairPoint. Thanks.
Because something is clearly wrong if you're on hold for that long.
On Thursday, we took Joy's video complaint straight to the FairPoint chairman and CEO, Gene Johnson.
We don't know what happened. That's the first case I've heard of a customer being on for an extended period of time.
But News 9 viewers emailing us Wednesday night and Thursday say they're still hitting the same roadblock. Rhonda Wesolowski writes, "Last night I waited 2 hours for online live chat help before I had to give up." Barbara Lawrence emails, "I tried for over 90 minutes Tuesday evening." Lynn Martell writes that the chat box has been up for over 4 hours with no help. The company brought in more customer service help, but Johnson admits the directions for how to switch over accounts online could have been better.
We could have done a better job of communicating them, you know, with the customers. We're sorry we didn't, and we're really sorry we inconvenienced customers.
Johnson says progress is steady. He hopes to have all the problems taken care of within the next couple of days.
So I think we're very close to being over the hump on this.
But the CEO says he's expecting a new hurdle. In just a couple of weeks, the company's first bills are going to go out, and he says there will be problems. But he says FairPoint has brought in extra support staff to handle those expected problems, and he says the company is prepared. Now, as for refunds for these customers who have been without email for a few days, a spokesperson for the company says they are looking into that, but they haven't made a decision just yet. Live in the newsroom, I'm Josh Davis, WMUR News 9.
And if you are frustrated facing similar email transfer issues, we want to hear from you. Send a video response to ulocal.wmur.com.